them back to God. They didn't keep going back to their bodies, but now we have power, we have authority, and we can stand. We can stand on our own. We can control the devil. The devil has no power over us any longer. Jesus has taken the power from him, and he has given it back to us. We lost it in the garden, but Jesus has given it back to us. Hallelujah. Jesus has given us the power, he has given us the authority all over again, and we are reconciled back to our Maker. We can go directly to him. We can talk to him directly now, and he will hear us and he will answer us. How? If we walk in his plan and in his purpose. Romans chapter 8, somebody there. How? If we continue to live and walk in his plan and his purpose for our life, we can approach him and he can help us. And the Holy Spirit can also come for our eternity and pray for us. Praise the Lord. Are we there? Hallelujah. Let's read from verse 26. Or let's read from verse 18. Let's read from verse 18 and see. Yet what we suffer now is nothing compared to the glory it will reveal to us later. For all creation is waiting eagerly for that future day when God will reveal who his children will have. Against its will, all creation was subjected to God's cause. Can you hear that? Against its will, all nature was subjected to God's cause because of what we suffered in the Garden of Eden. But with eager hope, the creation looks forward to the day when it will join God's children in glorious freedom from death and decay. For we know that all creation has been groaning as in the pains of childbirth right up to the present time. And we believers also groan, even though we have the Holy Spirit within us as a foretaste of future glory. For we long for our bodies to be released from sin and suffering. That is what Jesus did for us. Released us from sin and suffering. We too wait with eager hope for the day when God will give us our full rights as his adopted children, including the new bodies he has promised us. We will be given this hope when we were saved. Do you get that? When salvation came, we were given this hope of eternity. If we already have something, we don't need to hope for it. But if we look forward to something we don't yet have, we must wait patiently and confidently. Now from verse 26, where I'm going to. And the Holy Spirit helps us in our weakness. For example, we don't know what God wants us to pray for, but the Holy Spirit prays for us with goodness that cannot be expressed in words. And the Father who knows all acts, knows what the Spirit is saying, for the Spirit prays for us, believers, in harmony with God's own will. And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose for them. Can you hear that? For God makes things to work together for good for those who love him and are called according to his purpose. God makes all things good for those who love him. Do you love him? How do you show that you love God? By obeying his instructions. He said God makes all things work for good for those who love him and are called for his purpose. Are you working in the plan and purpose of God for your life? That is the only way you can approach the throne of grace. You can approach God directly and you can hear from him directly. When you are working according to his plan, you are working according to his purpose. God makes everything good for you when you love him. How do you show that you love God? When you obey his commandments, when you obey his instructions, when you write this word on the tablet of your heart, you meditate upon it day and night. Because therein in the book of Joshua we are told that we will have good success and we will prosper. You want to prosper? You're looking for prosperity? It's in the world. You want to succeed in life? It's in the world. You want things to work together for good for you? It's in the world. Obedience to the world brings about a change and a turnaround in our lives. Everything may look hopeless now. Go back everything looks so hopeless, as if it is empty, as if it is void. Just like when God created the world and the whole place was empty and darkness covered the sun, everywhere was darkness. But the Bible says that the Spirit of God moved over the waters. Go back to God and ask for the Holy Spirit in you, so that the hopelessness can be turned around. The vehicle can be filled. The valley can be filled. The mountain can be leveled. The crooked way can be made straight. Because we have been given power, we have been given authority. Jesus has restored it unto us. No condemnation against us that are in Christ Jesus. The moment you are in Christ Jesus, there's no more condemnation. There's no more fear. There's no more condemnation. Just for you to walk in authority. I'm walking in authority, living life without apology. Because our Father is the creator of heaven and earth. Because our Father holds the life. Because Jesus is risen. Because we are serving a living God. We are not of them that they will say, where is your God? Like the prophet of Baal. And they called on their God, they called on their God. They called on Baal and all of Baal, and Baal could not appear. All through the day, Baal could not save them. We are not of them that are serving the God that has ears that cannot hear. We are not of them that are serving the God with eyes that cannot see. We are not of them that are serving graven image. We are not serving the God of the Egyptians that has hand cannot stay, that has eyes cannot see. But we are serving a living God. The God that can turn everything around. The God that makes all things work together for good for those who love Him. Go and love God. Love Him with the whole of your heart. Because He first loves. The Bible says, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should become the sons of God. And He first loved us by sending forth His only begotten Son to die for our sins, to shed His blood, to reconcile us back to Him, to return the authority, to return the power, to become the victories that were lost in the Garden of Eden. Go and love Him. Just love Him. You want this to work better for good for you? Love God. Walk in His plan. Walk in His purpose. And see things turn around for good for you. See the impossible becomes possible. See the hopelessness turn around. See failure becomes success. And walk in prosperity and in peace. Jesus said, my peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in Him. Trust Him. Because the authority has been restored. Our crown of glory and the crown of honor that was set in the book of Psalm chapter 8 has been restored unto us. And when we continue to walk in His plan and His purpose, all that we have lost in the past will be restored unto us. Have you lost anything in life? Still thank God, because it's because of God that you have not lost all. If you have lost anything at all in life, in the past years, in the past months, in the past days, it is because of God that you have not lost all. And see, the book of Joel makes it clear that the God of restoration will restore. He said, now I will restore to you the years that the captive one has eaten, the locusts, the proper one. He now said, my armies that I sent in your midst. So God will now restore the armies. Only if we will walk in His plan and we will walk in His purpose and we will do His will. Because Jesus has given us the power. There's no need for us to live in sin any longer. We have power and authority over sin. We can say stop to sin. We can say stop to the flesh. We can control our flesh now. We can control our eyes. We can control everything now. The loss of the flesh, the loss of the life, the eyes and the kind of life has no power over us any longer. Because Jesus has given us power over it. The loss of the flesh, we can control the flesh. The loss of the eyes, I can control my eyes and tell my eyes, I don't want to look this way, I want to look this way. Is it not possible? It's possible. It's possible. If I don't want my eyes to see anything that is, I can tell my eyes, don't even bother to look that way. We are going this way. And the heart says, yes, we are going this way. Because, is that not true? God has given us the power. It's been restored. Hallelujah.
So we are walking in authority, living life without apology. Do we understand? Let's sing it. I'm walking in authority, living life without apology.
I'm not
wrong then. I belong here.
Praise the Lord.